The Intelligence Bureau of India launched Operation Octopus, raiding 93 points of presence of the Popular Front of India, or PFI, across 15 states and arrested 106 members. They found incriminating documents plotting the replacement of the democratic government with an Islamic caliphate and the assassination of political leaders. They had specific plans to subjugate the majority Hindu population.
The PFI is a radical Islamic organization pretending to be a youth development movement. An unnamed intelligence source said that while PFI has hundreds of thousands of members, only those directly involved in terrorism were the targets.
Each of those arrested are involved in terror-related activities, ranging from funding to organizing radicalization and training camps for gullible Muslim youth.
Of those arrested, 45 were already part of national-level terror cases, and the rest were involved in local terror activities. Many were part of the banned Students Islamic Movement of India and Indian Mujahideen.
A multi-agency control room anchored by the Intelligence Bureau set up in New Delhi, roped in many agencies such as the National Investigation Agency and the Enforcement Directorate. Several aircraft were ready to bring arrested terror operatives to interrogation centers. Despite an operation of this size, the surprise and secrecy of execution was astounding. Some Indian news sources say the planning started 3 to 4 months ago after consultations with Muslim leaders. About 200 NIA officials, accompanied by AD sleuths and a posse of state police officers, visited every target site. They covered Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Delhi, Assam, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Goa, West Bengal, Bihar, and Manipur. The meticulously planned operation took the PFI by surprise, denying them the time to organize protests or induce riots.
A centrally pooled set of technical specialists from various agencies broke down any technology obfuscations set up by targeted criminals. It took several months of patient evidence gathering, on the ground and technology leveraged spotting, constant location locking of suspects, and meticulous cross-referencing with financial, telecommunication, and location records. NIA has an enviable record of a 95% conviction rate for its cases. They wanted to create airtight case documents to survive the left-leaning and lenient judicial system.
In 2014, about 18 Kerala youth, including several girls, were apprehended in Afghanistan. These individuals had gone to Afghanistan to join the Islamic State and, when captured, feigned trickery and espoused peace and desire to rejoin the society back home. Thankfully, the government did not buy such drama but kept them under interrogation and investigation. Many of those captured belonged to the PFI. New Delhi realized the enormity of the radicalization of Muslims, especially in Kerala. It has since initiated a comprehensive de-radicalization program in Kerala and other locations. Unnamed sources say the institutional memory from that experience and resources developed during all these years came in handy for the agency.
We can only tell you that we have a tremendous amount of data on the activities of PFI and their associates, both in India and abroad. Each of the suspects arrested were trailed or monitored for months. Their exact locations, possible hideouts, and quarters from where they might get support were all kept handy before the raids.
In response to this swoop, the PFI launched a national strike, seeking to shut down businesses. Barring some radicalized locations in Kerala, this call failed. In some towns, even in Kerala, PFI operatives were attacked by locals and chased them away. Some cadre called out in support of Pakistan, alienating them further from mainstream India.
Reviewing the nation's internal security, the Minister of Home Affairs, Amit Shah, was stunned by the extent of radicalization of this group. While he asked his organization to conduct this exercise, National Security Advisor Ajit Doval and IB Chief Tapan Dekar supervised the drive.
If you like this content, please press the like button and share it with your family and friends. Please consider subscribing to this channel. It is free. Press the bell icon to receive notifications about new content.